Hello and greetings from Iceland, but today's story is all about the different photo angles and a different route up to the volcano, and it's also about air pollution and other useful information for our guests. But like we expected, the search and rescue team has already brought one exhausted family back to safety, but it could have turned out bad. And in that case, the tourists were reluctant to accept a ride from the mountain because they worried about the cost. So it is good for you to know that our search and rescue teams do this for free. Even the idiots get it free of charge. And this is how they do their financing. Explaining why we have such a huge fireworks show on New Year's Eve. So we take care of our search and rescue teams like this, and they take care of us. So don't hesitate to ask for help. That is their job, and they do it with a smile. But this incident that just occurred was also because of lack of information on our behalf. So that is something that civil defense is trying to fix, or to make sure that people don't go up there in just any weather. Like it was closed there today, and you can see why on the webcams. So I am leaving a link to safetravel.is and another site with good information, or must-see websites for those of you who are planning a trip up here. But back to my trip. This was shot the day after it started, but I didn't go all the way up, no. It's just been very crowded up there. Thousands of people posting images and videos every day, and all about the red stuff. And it is not for me to be chasing the same as all others, or not yet at least. So I started to focus more on the surroundings. I was going to go up there this weekend, but the weather has been awful. But I will go there before I have to go up north again to finish some editing. I'm having problems with sound recording here in Reykjavík, and I don't work as fast like when I'm back home. So before I go north, I will take my Nikon with me to the volcano and the zoom lens and the drone, the whole package, and come back with plenty of footage. But the air pollution up there is already a problem. About 5,000 people visited the volcano last Friday, and like we knew before the eruption, this is a huge tourist sensation. It's getting hard to find rental cars and hotels in Iceland, but before the eruption, this was very strong tourist summer, and it can be very hard to even park the car by the hiking route up to the volcano. And here we have the Reykjanes Peninsula. The volcano is situated just by the town Grindavík, and we drive only for 5 minutes from Grindavík to get to this place. The first news indicated that the hiking route was 17 kilometers, but that turned out to be wrong. The first part of it is the same hiking route that visitors used to visit the volcano last year, and the first part of it is fairly easy, or until you get to this steep hill up on a mountain. From there, you will walk beside the lava field from last year, or until you find the cozy fireplace we got there for you. And then we have another car park, a bit further west, and there is a mountain ridge there that you can hike up on and get very good view, but it's not the right way to the volcano. There are lava fields to cross, and it's still molten lava under there, and they will be warm for decades. And in addition, the earthquakes before the eruption made some openings there. So it's a place to stay away from. And then we are into the third route, the one that hasn't been mentioned before. So I had to check it out for you, or where it starts. And back to the map, the airport route between Reykjavík and Keflavík International Airport is here. And just around here, we turn south. And the first part of the road leads us to the hiking route to Mount Keilir, which was for a long time the center of attention, or the place where we believed that the eruption last year would take place. And I am adding GPS tags in the video description, and you can go there on any car, but it is a rocky road, and it leads us to a volcano called Trölladyngja, and there are two platforms there made by energy companies while they were drilling for hot water a few years back, and it is the only place around where you can park a car. The road is very narrow, and to try to park the car outside the road is categorized as off-road driving, and it's not cheap if you get caught. And this is platform number one, and the second one is a bit higher up, but you will need a good dip to get up there. And between the platforms, there is this intersection where we actually have this old road leading further south, but it's closed for cars. But that is where the hiking starts to the volcano. And as I was there, four guys on bicycles were coming back from the volcano and told me that according to the GPS trackers that they had, it was 28 kilometers back and forth. So this option is not just for hikers, it's also for bicycles. And furthermore, if you are going to be hiking there, the Reykjanes Peninsula is a wonderland of its own. And this route is by far more beautiful than the other one. So this evening, when I was shooting there, it was my second trip there in 2 days. But I was coming back from that place when the eruption started. And the second trip was more about to figure out the different photo angles before and after it got dark. But the 2021 eruption, you can see the crater in the background, took place at more elevation. So I could do some playing around with the zoom lens from far away, like behind the city, because I could see the lava come flying up from there. But this new fissure sits so low that it was a bit disappointing that I didn't get a better angle from there. But then, this volcano will go on for most likely months, and the fissure might just as well build up a cone like last year. But all we have now is a lava pond, and it's only a matter of time when it takes off and into this valley. And it has been predicted that lava from this volcano could travel north, putting a town at risk that is called Vogar, and you see here. But I think it's unlikely though, although this is a sealed volcano in the forming, and such eruptions can go on for years. So I will show you a lava prediction map when it will be available. But as this looks now, if this eruption would turn out to be of similar size as last year, it's no harm done. And notice those volcano ridges. They line all up from southwest to northeast, and between them we have valleys with all sorts of young geological formations. And my favorite valley is the one next to the east from where the eruption takes place now. There is a road through that valley, and I'm linking to a video that I shot from that road a few years ago, just a little sample of the landscape. But you have to pay the road toll. We don't want to insult the sheep. And when the car rentals in Iceland find out that I'm telling you about this road, they will not like it. But it is all about to take it slowly and don't damage the car. It's just a bumpy ride, and when you take it slow, it's just more to see. And those valleys, they look best late summer or when we get into the fall. And overall, it is a very strange fact that tourists travel for a long way to visit the highlands of Iceland for a landscape of this kind. But we have it just by our doorsteps in Reykjavík, or a kind of mini version of what we see on the highlands. It's all here, large rows of craters, the plate boundaries, young lava fields and old lava fields, mossy lava fields, simple color palettes or very complicated. Then we have rift valleys, hot springs, and of course explosion craters, not so old. So I would use the time well and try to discover the whole peninsula, because in a way it is like a geological calendar where multiple layers of lava are overlapping each other in this youngest part of Iceland. Then we have the tough mountains from the Ice Age, formed under glacier, sticking up here and there, but the sealed volcanoes are drowning them little by little, like we see after the 2021 eruption, by the crater since then. And we Icelanders, we somehow ignored this part of our country for a long time. And a part of the reason might be the proximity to the capital. The peninsula just is there, as usual, and no one really cared about it until last year. So I am leaving links to some of my older videos about the peninsula, since the events that are unfolding now are just a tiny little part of a larger story. And if you know a bit more about the larger story, this eruption will just be more exciting. And we are very glad that things turned out like they did, especially the people in Grindavík. But you cannot forget though that this is just a tiny little fissure, and we will get larger eruptions, not as well situated. And one of my upcoming videos is all about the volcanoes around the city. And even though I believed I had seen it all, I found myself often staring at the screen while flying the drone around the city and thinking what a place to build a capital. And we are still building the city closer to the plate boundaries. And when we look at the map once again, I have added the volcanic systems on the peninsula. The eruption takes place here now, and this is where they planned to build a new domestic airport. And they have been doing some wind tests there for years now. So me and many others said back then that it would be a ridiculous idea if we are supposed to believe the experts who told us back then that the Reykjanes Peninsula was getting ready for a new chapter of frequent volcanic activity that might go on for 200 years. And it's very simple, the experts got it right. So it was announced just 2 days ago that those airport plans were going up in smoke. And it is good that this project never took off. We could have burned up way more money than we already did. Be somewhere around here, seen from the drone. Or on a lava field that is not so old. A geologist said in the news the other day that we Icelanders should prepare for a new reality. But the biggest threat for the capital might be the air pollution. It has already started, and I'm leaving a link to the gas pollution forecast. It's on the weather pages. So there are many angles to cover from this eruption. Not just the volcano itself, but all the side stories from this huge unfolding story. So I will be going up there as soon as the visibility gets better. So I will have plenty of footage to work with in my updates. Or until I get back to Reykjavík. I'm going north 500 kilometers to do some editing and some work. And then coming back to get more footage and such. And one of my next videos will be about the subglacial eruption that might take place soon in Grímsvötn, which is a volcano under Iceland's largest glacier. But we have actually had false alarms from there before, and I'm linking to videos where I covered that. But we have been seeing some mighty strong signs of unrest lately. And as far as I can understand from our experts, they say that we should prepare for an eruption there soon. Or as I've often mentioned before, my friends, those are strange times. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.